What the hell are you doing?
It's Tai Chi, Doug.
So, why are you doing Tai Chi?
I do all of that so I can do this.
How the hell does Tai Chi make your fist glow?
It's about chi, it's about inner peace, it's about being one with... Ah! Spider!
Inner peace, huh?
Oh, shut up. Hey guys, welcome to Film Learning, the show dedicated to learn you some filmmaking and learn you good. Well, this one's been a long time coming, so why don't we just heck out a few requests? You think I was gonna forget, didn't you, Nathan? It seems that you guys want an Iron Fist effect, I think. So, that's what we're doing today, guys. Now, I know I'm a little bit late to the party here, but I'm proud to say I actually developed my own technique for this, so that's why it took so long. Now, in order to complete this effect, you need to shoot your actor turning their fist on, and making sure they keep that fist as still as possible. Now, the Tai Chi is optional, as well as that creepy stare I'm doing.
My God.
Now, I also want to recommend that you light your fist as evenly as possible, so no shadows and no highlights. It just makes it easier when we're creating this effect in Photoshop later. Now, speaking of Photoshop, you do need a copy of both After Effects and Photoshop, because we're going to be switching between the two of them. Now, enough talk. Let's light this bitch up. Okay, guys, so here we are in... Well, you know. I've got my footage set up all ready to go, so let's take a look. So I'm staring at a fist. Enough said about that, the better. So our first tip is to head up to Layer and add ourselves a new null object. And let's call it Hand Track. Now guess what? We're gonna track our hand. I know, shocking. So let's head on over to our tracker controls and with our footage selected, hit Track Motion. From there, we just need to find a sweet spot on our hand to track. This part looks pretty good to me. Now let's hit the play button and let the tracker do its thing. Done. We'll now hit Apply and OK. So we've tracked our hand. I guess we better find something to add that track to. And here's where things change from every other Iron Fist effect tutorial out there. What we'll do now is head along the timeline until we find a point where we want our Iron Fist to turn on. Let's then head up, grab the pen tool, and we're gonna mask out our entire hand, and wrist too if it's in the shot. Now guys, if you do want to use the roto tool to do this, be my guest, but I personally think the pen tool's faster. Okay, so we've got our arm cut out. Now what? Well, we're going to save this frame and export it to Photoshop, of course. So let's head up to Composition, Save Frame As, and save the frame as a Photoshop still. We'll then pop over to Photoshop with a funny sound effect and keep working. Righto, we've now opened Photoshop and our fist is open. Before we go any further, I'm just going to grab our magic eraser tool and just click on the black section to remove the background completely. There we go. So, what now? I'll tell you, just settle down, alright? Just calm down. Our first step is to head up to Image, then Adjustments, and then we're going to head down and click Invert. That way, the dark parts of our actor's hand are now light, because if your hand is lit up from the inside, these will be the parts where the light peeks through. We're then going to head back up to Image, head to Adjustments, and we're going to select Black and White. And that will make our image black and white. Now gang, the whole idea here is to use our actual fist still here to create an illumination map for our glow. In order to do that, we have to use the light and dark parts of our hand to tell After Effects where we want the glow to appear. And here's the beauty of this. If you've lit your hand evenly, then you now have free rein to make whatever custom illumination map you wish. So let's now talk about how we make that illumination map, because it's pretty easy, but it does require a little bit of patience. What we'll be doing is essentially darkening the image with the burn tool, where we want parts of the fist to remain visible, and then using the dodge tool to lighten the areas where we want the glow to be present. And finally, we're gonna crank down the burn tool's size and draw some custom vein maps as well. So let's start by grabbing the burn tool from the menu. Here we go. I'll then crank up the size and turn the exposure down a touch. I'll then go around the image, darkening the parts that I want the glow to avoid. So the fingers up here, and the side of the thumb, and just down the side of the hand. Now guys, I'm doing nice, even strokes, and then I'm switching from shadows, to mid-tones, to highlights as I go, because I want the colour to fade down from dark to light evenly. And that's what gives our final effect that look for the glow light falling off inside the hand. Now you might say that you could just mask and feather these layers and adjust it that way, but I honestly believe this is a much better option as feathering is always the exact thickness around your whole mask. But with this technique, you can use the different exposure percentages and brush sizes to really dial in an individual layered look. So I've finished with the burn tool, time to grab the dodge tool and lighten up some of the areas that I'd like the glow to be more pronounced on. For example, around this knuckle area here. So we'll dial down the exposure and then add some slight highlights to the fingers as well, just so our glow peeks through a little. So as you can see, the basic idea is the same as the burn tool, just the opposite effect. Once you're done, your hand should look similar to this, but we've missed something. The veins, you big dummy, where are the veins? Well, let's do them now, okay? Firstly, let's grab our burn tool again. Here we go. And from there, let's dial down the brush size and change the setting to shadows. And all we're gonna do is just draw a vein-shaped line where we'd like them to appear on our hand, like so. We can then follow that up by drawing another, and another. We can then also vary their thickness by lowering the brush size as well and adding a few more veins. And guys, if you want to have your veins stand out a little bit more, you can just turn that exposure up or just go over them again with the burn tool. I recommend making them harsher around the lighter areas to make them stand out more, and then fading them down in the darker areas. But the end result should look like this. And there you have it, we've just made a custom illumination map for our Iron Fist with our fist. So let's save this, name it Fist Map, and then we'll head back to After Effects to get this glow started. Okay, we're back in After Effects, so our first step is to import both our fist still and our fist illumination map. So let's grab both of these stills and drop them into our timeline on the same point that we saved our still at. We'll then parent them to our null object using the pick whip. There we go. And, well, that looks really bad. So let's start fixing it up. First off, we're going to right click on our illumination map and hit pre-compose. And we'll just name that map. And we're just going to leave that be for now. In fact, let's turn it off because we have a little bit of work to do on that hand underneath. So let's select the hand underneath. Let's then head up to Effect, Stylize and add a glow. Time to tweak some stuff. Let's change the threshold to 50%, the radius to 400, and the intensity to 1.9. From there, we need to yellow this fist up a little. To do that, we'll head to Effect, Color Correction, and add ourselves a tint. We'll then head down and change its map white color to a nice orange. That looks pretty good. Lastly, let's change the transfer mode on that fist to add. Now I know what you're thinking. Still looks pretty bad, Grant. So let's move on. Our next step is to turn our illumination pre-comp map back on, and then we're going to change the track mat on our fist below to Luma Mat. Now we're getting somewhere. Time to jump into that pre-comp and do some tweaking. Firstly, let's select our fist still, head to Effect, Color Correction, and add ourselves a brightness and contrast. And what we'll do is hit the stopwatch on both brightness and contrast on the first frame. Head forward around 25 frames or around 1 second, and then we'll crank the brightness up to say 22, and the contrast to around 50. What this will do is gradually make the darker parts darker and the lighter parts lighter. And if we head back to our final comp, you can see that by animating that brightness and contrast, it allows our glow to become much more pronounced. Now having said all that, you may want to have a play and find what settings work for your hand. Now from there, and this is just a personal preference, but I added a couple of adjustment layers on my hand. I grabbed the pen tool and then I masked around some of the areas where the veins were. For example, on the wrist and on the back of the hand here. I then added a camera lens blur to each section to soften the veins, as personally I felt they stood out too much and this made them a bit more subtle. You can see a comparison between the two on screen right now. One has the blur layers and one doesn't. Whether you do this or not, it's totally up to you guys. Okay, last step with our illumination map is to head back to our final comp, hit T to bring up opacity, set it down to zero, hit the stopwatch, and head down the timeline until after our glow starts to kick in, and then we'll bump it up to 100. Our glow will now gradually turn on. Whew, we're almost done. Just gotta add a few cherries on top to make this look even cooler. Firstly, let's head up, add two new adjustment layers, and then we'll name one Glow, and then we'll name the other one Fall Off. Starting with our glow layer, let's grab the pen tool and draw a rough mask around our hand. We'll then feather that out around 130 pixels. Let's then head to Effect, Stylize, and add ourselves yet another glow. We'll then crank the threshold to 75, the radius way out to 750, and lastly, change the A color to a bright yellow. Now for real, last step. Let's select our fall-off adjustment layer, grab the pen tool,
and let's draw some rough masks around areas that you think will be affected by the glow from your hand. Let's say the chest and your face. There we go. We'll then feather them out anywhere from 100 to 200 pixels. From there, I used Colorista to not only brighten the image, but I also added a slight yellow tint to my image as well. If you don't have Colorista, just use whatever color correction plugins you have, as it's a pretty easy effect to achieve. From there, let's hit T to bring up opacity, let's hit the stopwatch, set it to zero, and then let's sync it up with the glow fading in. So head to the point where our iron fist is all lit up, and then we'll crank the opacity up to 100. And if we check out a preview, that, my friends, is another shot done.
Add up all of those steps and you get something like this.
So why are you doing Tai Chi?
I do all of that so I can do this. So guys, that's my take on the Iron Fist effect from Iron Fist. As you can see, it's really not that hard to create your own custom Iron Fist effect. And I do mean custom, because you can create whatever illumination map in your fist you like. And that's really the best part of this technique, and it's what's lacking in every other Iron Fist effect tutorial out there. Now guys, if you did like the whole Iron Fist effect of him punching the ground and it breaking up, just let me know if you want a tutorial by sounding off down in the comments. Just be aware, I did use some paid assets from actionvfx.com. I think I used their ground bursts, their ground cracks, and some of their ground hits from their paid collections. And I highly recommend you checking them out. They even have a bunch of free stuff on their site to download, so by all means, check them out. They've been a friend for Film Learning for a very long time now, and I'm hoping to maybe rope them back in for the 60k comp. I haven't told them yet. But once again, friends, that is, of course, my time. If you enjoyed the video, please like and share it. If you're new here and you want to help us on our quest to 60,000 subs and beyond, click my face right there. Our last two episodes of Film Learning are right there, as well as my social media above my head, just if you want to stay up to date with stuff, and my Patreon stuff is right there. But until next time, and I get through all of that crap, keep learning!